Al-Haq is the first Palestinian human rights organization. Its work is based on taking the violations that occur and addressing them using international law and putting the arguments forward to the international community to take their obligations under international law seriously and ensure compliance with international law. So our work touches on documentation, legal research, advocacy, developing reports, and we also, in addition to addressing the violations of the Israeli occupation, we address Palestinian violations as well, and particularly those from Palestinian security officials and their apparatus. We have two field researchers that are based in Gaza, and those two field researchers, Mohammed and Tariq, tried to cover as much ground as possible to document the violations and did an excellent job. At the same time, worried about their families and how they are also going to survive this bombardment. But they got through it again, fine, and they've collected a significant amount of information. But at the same time, we can't do this work alone. And so we worked in collaboration with other human rights organizations based in Gaza as a collective unit to collect more information after a ceasefire was reached. So that way, all of this information is compiled and not duplicated, and we can use it in the future as soon as in the coming weeks with the meeting with the Commission of Inquiry into Gaza. Well, I mean, this particular incident, this increase in hostilities has its own issues that need to be addressed through the Commission of Inquiry, moving up through the international community, and the reports that we have, the documentation that we have will contribute to their report, but then their report and the information therein needs to be followed up. And it's that follow-up that can ensure that this isn't just one of another series of increase in hostilities to come. Because so long as the root causes continue to exist, we're going to continue to see these things. And that's why we are pushing for Palestine to accede to the International Criminal Court, to open this venue for justice and make it accessible to the Palestinians, with the hope that the international community will be able to put some sort of pressure on Israel to end its policies, to end the occupation, and lead to the Palestinian right to self-determination being realized. Human rights defenders have a very fulfilling but frustrating job at the same time, because you are defending the side of the oppressed. And there's a reason that there is an oppressed and an oppressor. The oppressor, in terms of tangible power, the balance is very asymmetrical. But as human rights defenders, we have to keep challenging that power balance and pushing things along to make sure that those that are oppressing know that someone is watching, someone is taking note, and someone is trying to take action. And we have to have faith that eventually the tide will turn and there will be justice. And we have to keep that on the horizon in order to be able to continue to push forward on this work. And sometimes the successes aren't noted in a way that people would like them to be. But at least getting the wheels of justice to turn to address a particular issue, we have to see that as a relative success as well. Well, in the end, the work that we are doing as Al-Haq is part of the global pursuit of justice. And the international organizations that work on issues ranging from Asia to Africa to South America to anywhere else in the world, that move towards global justice is positive for us, because when there is progress on the pursuit of accountability, when there is progress on the pursuit of addressing extraterritorial violations in different jurisdictions, those developments contribute to the Palestinians' pursuit for justice as well. So we don't need to ask for anything new to be done by these organizations, just to continue moving forward in the right direction. Because in the end, we're not going to be able to change everything on our own. But so long as we're contributing to that positive direction, we have to have faith that eventually it'll work. Well, I mean, I've only been with Al-Haq for about 8 years now, and we've seen, during that time, I've seen various methods of restrictions on our work, from travel bans to denial of entry, to detention of field researchers. And before my time, there were raids in Al-Haq's offices. This is part of our work. I mean, if we were, if we didn't face some difficulties, then we probably wouldn't be doing our work the right way. So long as we have those that are involved in human rights violations unhappy with us, then we must be doing the right thing. And it's a balance, I think, from their side as well, as to what kind of restrictions they can put on us, because putting too much may make our job easier to some extent, because it'll get more attention to us. So that's why one of the most recent developments is our general director had a travel ban imposed for a number of years, and now he's better able to travel, because sometimes denying that can cause more problems. We look forward to more methods of or attempts to suppress our work, because we feel like we're going to continue to fight this battle in the right way and likely get reactions. But this is part of our work.
Help protect human rights defenders on the front line. Contribute at www.frontlinedefenders.org/donate. Thank you.